Hey there. Here's another tune I love to play. It's a Gypsy jazz standard. It's called Dark Eyes, Les Yeux Noirs. And I've been talking too much and playing too little, so I'm just going to play it. And if you want to learn more about it, I'll give you some other lesson pointers at the end of the song. So here's Dark Eyes. Used to be a Russian lullaby. This is a really fun song. It's pretty easy to play. It's based around what works best to solo on it is the E harmonic minor scale, and that's I'm talking trumpet pitch. So if you're a concert instrument like guitar, a C instrument, you'll be in a D harmonic minor. So but forget about that. We're playing trumpet, so we'll talk trumpet notes. So E harmonic minor is the E minor scale. And when we say harmonic minor, there's a half step between the seventh degree and the eighth degree of the minor scale, the natural minor scale. If that doesn't make sense to you, you know, brush up on your music theory. Otherwise, you know, just learn it. So here it is, E harmonic minor, just one octave. Okay, so another thing that I was using quite a bit that time through was chromatic scale. The great thing about the chromatic scale is that it fits in any key. When you use it in a particular key, there are some notes that sound better to start and stop from, but for the most part, the scale works in any key. One of the exercises that I threw in there is one that goes like this. Etc. So what I'm doing for that is I'm going up three notes, down one, and then back up three. So I'll do it slowly. Okay, etc. That will take a little bit of practice to get it fast, another additional challenge to do that is to triple tongue it, which I should probably practice. Anyway, you get the idea. Let's see, one other thing that's really useful in that is, again, the diminished chord or scale. And I usually think of this as either C diminished, E flat diminished, F sharp diminished, or A diminished. They're all the same thing, the same notes. They're not quite the same thing, they're used different harmonically. But here is those sets of notes. And that leads into the tonic. So, okay, so that's another soloing idea that you can use that works really well. The last thing is something that I like to do when I'm improvising, and I'm not thinking notes or tonalities or anything. I'm certainly listening. But it's more of a physical sensation, and one that I like that works well for this tune is just using the middle valve and the open. And to me, I'm not thinking notes, even though it is B to C, F sharp to G, E flat to E natural. Even though it is those notes, I'm not really thinking that. I'm just kind of feeling what it feels like to do that. Here's an example. So there's another thing to mess around with. Just, you know, you can't go wrong just using those two valve combinations. You could do all kinds of stuff with that. So there's just three little tips that would help to get you through this. And yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoy the tune. Have fun. Good luck with the practice.